SPSS stands for the Statistical Package for the Social Sciences, and today we'll talk about one method to help prep for running your tables in SPSS. That specifically is how to print the SPSS codebook, which is a very simple process. I'm assuming that you already have some prior knowledge of how to put your data into the Data Values tab, either keying it in directly or copying in from another program such as Excel. And we are assuming that you know how to enter the variable information in the Variables tab. So the assumption is that you have everything in SPSS and you're just about ready to run the tables. For this and other videos on SPSS, we're going to use the sample survey that you did at the beginning of the semester, or that most of you did at the beginning of the semester. And here are some of the questions that were in that survey. So now let's turn to how to print the SPSS codebook. You would do this to identify the variables that you have in your file and where they're placed. You would also be able to review to see if you've identified everything correctly in terms of the missing values and the variable type. You can also check for typographical errors. And for me, very important is I need to be able to tell that your SPSS file prep work has been completed. This is a very simple task. You will use File, Display Data File Information, and Working File. I know you can stop the video to see this, but these are the dialog boxes that you will see. There are a couple of notes, and one is that you will have to switch to the output window to see the output. Unlike in some cases, when you click OK, the output window shows up on top of the SPSS variable or data windows. And then you'll be able to print this as well to a PDF or an Adobe Acrobat file, or save it, they call it export it, to Excel, Word, or some other format. So now let's do it. Let's print the SPSS codebook. Here we are, we happen to be in the variable view of our SPSS, and you'll see file shows up here, as well as in the data view, file is in the same place. And you'll notice that all of these tend to be the same, no matter which view you go to. So here we would go File, Display File Information, Working File. And then, as I said, you'll have to go to the SPSS output file. Well, this one happens to show up, but oftentimes you have to go down to the bottom and click to go to the output file. So here is file information, and this identifies all the various variables that we have in the file. You'll see question 1, A, B, C, D, E, and what position they are. So this is the first field, this is the second field. Think of them as the columns in your data file. And then here it identifies print books is question 1A, which is nominal level data. And then you'll notice down here at the bottom, frequency of eating in the car, we have listed as ordinal level data. And then there's some scale level. If you go down to the second table, which is the variable values, you'll see that the answers or the values for question 1, if there's a 1 in the file, that equates to yes. If there's a 2 in the file, it equates to no. So you'll notice down here that on question 3, it's never, seldom, occasionally, frequently, always. And you've got all of those data. Processing time. What would be the reason to print out an SPSS codebook? What is the difference between the two tables produced by SPSS, the variable information table and the variable values table? And finally, can you remember what the steps are to create the SPSS codebook? Well, here's your quick reminder. File, display file information, and working file. And now you'll be able to check your values and your variable information in SPSS before you move on to the next step of running frequency tables.